All right, guys, we're back again. I'm gonna try to do a video. I tell you, it's the end of August. Honey season is coming up really quick, and that's when people want to work on their four-wheel drives. Just the way it is. So I had a gentleman send this to me. It is, we're gonna unbox it together here. Just go in the shot. Got a little locker kit for a Suzuki Samurai. A yoke. Looks like it's been found at the bottom of a pond. A house that, same way, it's just covered in rust. Carrier. Now, according to the guy, basically what happened, they took it apart and they were going to do it themselves and realized they didn't have the tools, equipment, knowledge. I don't know what they didn't have, but they couldn't do it themselves, so they sent it to me. They tore it all apart and left it in the rain, apparently. Let's see what we got here. Pinion gear. Rain gear. Spider gears, cutest little spider gears you ever seen. Let's see. Something right on my ale. A bearing and a cap. Another cap bearing and bolts. Ah! New bearing, crush sleeve. Well, guys, this is how it was given to me, or sent to me. So, I told him I'd build it. So that's what we're gonna do. Man, what a mess. So, I'll start by having one of my guys go ahead and bead blast a lot of this stuff, and I'll put definitely this on the lathe. Go ahead and clean that up so the seal will actually seal. And I'll get everything else bead blasted. Now, I think what we'll do is videotape the assembly of this differential. This ought to be interesting. So, next time you see it, hopefully these parts will be clean. And we'll be pressing bearings and putting it back together. All right. I'll be right back. Guys, look, I'm back on the differential. I just wanted to quickly show you what I do to prep for this stuff. When I have something brought to me in a box, which, believe it or not, happens more than you think, I bead blast the carrier, the hat, here's the bolts, I cleaned all the bolts, I re-chased all the threads on the bolts, and I'm basically going back with a thread chaser, and I'm chasing all the threads on the carrier. I've also done that for the ring gear. Basically, I just want to make sure everything's good and clean before I try to do it, reassemble it. And basically, I just wanted to make sure this was actually caught, because, you know, somebody will think, man, he bought all new bolts and new carrier. I didn't. I just cleaned a lot of stuff. Y'all, I'm sure y'all understand that you can't afford to replace every part on one. unless they're broke. So this is what the customer brought me. He brought me all his own parts. So this is part of it, is cleaning it up. And I'm just showing you how I re-chase every thread on every piece so you don't have that problem. All right. I'll get back to you when I do the assembly. All right, guys, we're going to start assembling this rear end. I hope this is going to go pretty quick. First, we got a locker here that we're going to assemble. Hope everything gets in here. It starts out with these little pins that have springs. Got to use a little trans gel. And the pins go there. Side gets two as well. Brush washer. We'll slide this one on here. This one's ready to go in. Alright, guys, we're back. So, I guess it's been about 35-40 minutes has passed. The customer has found the parts that I was asking for. So we're going to assemble this thing real quick. If you remember, we put the spider gear on the end just like before. I'm just going to go ahead and put it back together like I had it. Now this thing has a spacer. This is the bottom. This is the piece he didn't have before. Just a square block with four holes in it. Basically goes in here like so. So now the spacer goes where that's moved in this. Alright guys, that's basically what it looks like on the inside. You got your cross pin and it basically centers up the locker. Just, you got to kind of hammer it in. It's going to be tight. Put these springs in. Spacer. That. Then half. Guys, now we just put the bolts in. Now what I'm going to do is use a little bit of Loctite. Wait a minute. Oh yeah, I can leave that one on. Alright. Just a little dab of do you. Specification, make sure I was right. It's 27 to 33 foot pounds. I'm gonna do a one lock flange and a vise so I can hold it. Yeah, I'm doing this. Check every one now. Okay, as far as the differential, all we have left is put the ring and ring gear on it. Torque it down and press the bearings on. I'm go ahead and put the ring gear on because that's what actually what keeps these pins from falling out is the ring gear. Once again, we can put a little Loctite on it. Remember, all the threads have been thoroughly cleaned on the bolts and the holes. I'm running this thing in with a quarter inch impact, mainly because I'll never get anywhere near the torque spec on it. That torque Torque spec on the ring gear is 58 to 65 foot-pounds.
Like I said,
quarter-inch impact can never get close to that.
Turn it around, let's see what we're doing here.
And this is not anything special. Oh, help her. Like I said, 58. That's all of them. I'll press the carrier bearings on and we'll have this one up. Carry y'all to the press so y'all can see exactly what I'm doing. Now, you don't absolutely have to use a press, but well, if you got it, you might as well use it. Alright guys, basically, whoa, that was too easy, but it won't come back off, huh? Alright, what I'm going to do is pull that bearing back off, and I will knurl the end of this thing so it's getting tight. No need to video that. That's just too time consuming. What I'm going to do is put y'all on hold. I'll get this done and then you can see what I've done. Okay, guys. So we discussed what we're doing with the ring and pinion. We've got the ring and pinion installed in the carrier. We put a locker in it. Next, we've pressed the bearing braces into the housing or the hog head, center section, whatever you'd like to call it. Next, we need to put the pinion in. Now, there's a lot of controversy or what have you on what it should feel like, what it should be like. Well, let me explain to you how this actually works, how a pinion is supposed to be set up, and go from there. Here's our pinion gear. Now the pinion gear will have a collar. This is actually a crush sleeve. It's got a little piece here that actually crushes as you tighten the pinion nut. It will go down against the bearing, like so. The outer bearing will come down and press against the pinion. Now, ideally, you put the nut and the flange on and tighten this, you'll tighten it and start to crush the sleeve. As you start to crush the sleeve, the two bearings will actually get tighter and tighter and tighter into the race. As it tightens up in the race, basically your preload is the amount of rotational force it takes to turn the pinion inside the race. Basically, you want to tighten it to where you actually have a measured preload on the nut that you're using to tighten it. I tell you what, easiest thing to do is just put this together and show you exactly what I'm talking about. Let's move to the other table. Alrighty. Here's our center section. I painted it because it was cast iron and it just looked awful. We have our new race, inner race, new outer race. Do is put the bearing in here. What I like to do is put just a little bit of lube on the bearings. You know, just a little bit of gear oil or assembly oil. Seal. Alright, that's better. Seals in flush, springs all the way in. Guys, I run this thing down and kind of compressed it, but that is nowhere near tight enough. Okay, that's really loose and there's still just a little bit of movement in it. I'm going to lock and I'm going to put this rest of it down by hand. Don't have to go very far. I That's 13 and a half, 13 and six. Specification. Preload 7.8 to 14.7. All right, guys, I'm well within specification. In fact, I'm right in the middle of the specifications. It feels pretty good. Go ahead and pop this nut plate. Guys, that's that. On the bench. All right, guys, let's get you where you can see a little better. We got our pinion in, we got a preload set. We're going to put the differential in and side cap set our back lash. Then we'll take some gear marking compound to make sure that the measurements we took before on the pinion shim is right. And that should be it. Should be ready to go. Come on. Alright guys, that's just run down slightly so I can get an idea of where we're at. Which that feels really close there. Sometimes, guys, it's tough to keep up with your tools. guys, that's 6,000.
It needs less, more than that. So what the spec is. Guys, I just looked at the specifications. The spec, according to Mitchell, is between 4 and 6 thousandths. I am dead on 6 thousandths. And I wouldn't want it much tighter than that. Let's see what happens when I torque the carrier down now. I don't know what a carrier's torque was. All right, let's recheck that. All right, guys, I don't know if you can see it or not. Let's see if I can get it where y'all can see. Zoom in at that gauge. Focus. All right, guys, here we go. That's what we got, 6 thousandths. And like I said, specifications between 4 and 6 thousandths. So we're in specs, and honestly, I think it's a little tight, but that's what the specification is what it is. Dead center. last thing I'll do I'll make sure these are good and tight. They'll move just a little tiny bit. There's that. Recheck it. Has me well within specs. Put the locks in. Just take a wrench. Guys, that's it. Put a little RTB around the flange, throw it in, throw some matches in, you're done. Alright, if you have any questions, just leave me a comment. I'll do my best to return any or answer any questions that you have. Guys, if there's something you've seen that you want more detail on, or you want to see again, or you want, you know, if you've seen a tool used that you want to know information about, you know, just leave me a question. I'll do what I can to answer them. If you like the content, give me a thumbs up. Tell me you like it, and I'll try to make more. I'm trying to do stuff that is not everyday common stuff. And let's be honest, I don't see a Suzuki rear end every day. If you have any other questions, please, like I said, leave me a comment. Till next time, I appreciate you watching. Thank you.